So economists have now come out and said that Donald Trump's economic plans, even though Donald promises he'll produce 6% yearly growth in GDP, they're now saying that we could see the GDP fall by as much as 3% per year if Donald Trump makes it to the White House and implements his economic policies. Now, this is horrible news for Donald Trump and for the American public and really for the world, because the United States economy crashing can have a ripple effect that can crash economies all over this planet. And the U.S. Chamber of Commerce has now come out and said that they cannot support the economic platform of Donald Trump, but not because of his pending recession. They don't like Donald Trump because he doesn't support, at least out loud, the Trans-Pacific Partnership. You see, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce wants the TPP to go into place because then all of their member corporations can ship jobs overseas, pay pennies on the dollars, not have to worry about worker protections, and increase their bottom lines. That's why they hate Donald Trump right now. It completely ignoring the fact that the best economists in the United States, the best economic institution, shows that his policies will lead to a nationwide, perhaps global, recession, which could destroy the economic futures of millions of American citizens, not to mention what it will do for the rest of the planet. But no, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce is absolutely fine with that. They just want to be able to ship their jobs over to India and China and not pay livable wages. Now, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce being against Donald Trump is actually fairly significant when you consider the fact that the U.S. Chamber is one of the most powerful lobbying organizations in this country. No other group holds as much power or as much money as the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, because they are tied to almost every major corporation in this country. And when they come out and say that we're not going to support Donald Trump's economic plan, that spells real trouble for Donald, because they control a lot of money. And if that money does not flow to Donald Trump's campaign, it's going to flow somewhere else. And that somewhere else is to Hillary Clinton and the Democratic Party. And if that money goes to the Democrats, Republicans can kiss the White House, the Senate, and the House of Representatives goodbye.